A severed head on a pike seemed such a grisly trophy to be displayed in the chapel at Chalon. And yet it took me weeks before I got up the nerve to ask Father Armand why he kept it. The ancient priest stared out the window for a long time, recalling days gone by. "I was there," he said finally, "at the Battle of the Catalonian Fields, fighting alongside Aetius and Theodoric the Goth. I knew there had been a battle here, decades ago. Peasants still overturned skeletons and broken shields with their plows from time to time. Who was it, Father?" I asked him. "Who were you fighting?" He turned back to regard me, paralyzing me in his old man's stare. "Attila the Hun," he said. And then he told me the story. The Huns rode out from the wilderness sometime in the 400s, eager to feast on a Roman Empire weak from internal corruption and the expansion of other barbarian tribes. It was the Huns who drove many of these other barbarians before them. They were terrifying warriors from the steppes of Asia, their bodies disfigured from ritual scarring, their legs deformed from a near lifetime in the saddle. Despite their fearsome aspect, the Huns might have been little more than raiders, had it not been for the leadership of Attila. He called himself the Scourge of God. Attila and his brother Bleda led the Huns not just to raid, but to devastate Scythia and Persia.
You challenge my every decision. It is as if you seek to lead the Huns yourself. Very well. The Iron Boar lairs near here. Let the one who kills this mighty beast lead our people. This way, Attila. Follow.
Bleda will lead us to ruin. Perhaps he should not return from his boar hunt. Accidents can happen.
Ride ahead and see if you can flush the boar out. Attila, coward, fight and earn your right to rule.
Let us waste our time. Let us follow Attila. We ride with you, Attila. Let us go. Bleda will soon seek you out. Some of our families are across the Western River. We should see to them. This road leads to a bridge in both directions. Northwest is the way we want. South leads to the Romans. Follow you, but we will follow you where you lead. Lead us to glory!
Thank you. Pizza. Die Brot Feuer. Time. 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 Барилгачин.
Some time ago, the Romans captured a number of Han villagers. Bleda arranged for their return, but I did not trust Bleda, and I do not trust the Romans. We should free them. No bargaining. Bleda is no more. When Attila returns to camp, he alone will rule the Huns. Attila is king of the Huns. He will lead us to victory against our blood enemy.
Ride ahead and see if you can flush the boar out. No more. When Attila returns to camp, he alone will rule the Huns.
Attila murdered Bleda. We were too late to stop the bloodshed. We are left with an honorless curse for a leader.
And what were you doing in the forest, noble archer, if not waiting to ambush Attila at Bleda's command? We are best rid of Bleda. Hail Attila! Against our blood enemies.
Brax, brother, ride ahead and see if you can flush the boar out. Attila, that boar would have killed me had you not intervened. Pity that none will ever learn of your loyalty. Archers, attack! Attila, coward, fight and earn your right to rule.
It was an ambush! Bleda tried to kill Attila. Bleda is not fit to rule. Let us slay the rest of the traitors. Bleda is no more. When Attila returns to camp, he alone will rule the Huns. Attila is king of the Hun. He will lead us to victory against our blood enemies.
Drax, brother. Ride ahead and see if you can flush the boar out. Attila, coward, fight and earn your right to rule.
Bleda wastes our time. Let us follow Attila. Bleda is no more.
When Attila returns to camp, he alone will rule the Huns.
We ride with you, Attila. Let us go. Bleda will soon seek you out. Some of our families are across the western river. We should see to them. This road leads to a bridge in both directions. Northwest is the way we want. South leads to the Romans. Attila, welcome. We are not many who follow you, but we will follow you where you lead. Lead us to glory.
Murdered Bleda. We were too late to stop the bloodshed. We are left with an honorless cur for our leader.
And what were you doing in the forest, noble archer, if not waiting to ambush Attila at Bleda's command? We are best rid of Bleda. Hail Attila! Attila is king of the Huns. He will lead us to victory against our blood enemies. We raised this Roman camp to the ground.
Some time ago, the Romans captured a number of Hun villagers. Bleda arranged for the return, but I did not trust Bleda, and I do not trust the Romans. We should free them. No bargaining. You would be wise to withdraw from our domain and pursue your petty conquests elsewhere, Hans.
Oh,
foolishly tempted our wrath.
Sicher, Bibo 2. Bärlich zu. Bärlich zu.
Over to Attila. You must take them by force.
Thank you. Wait!
I am the son of my foxes, a leader amongst my people. If you will free me, you will be rewarded.
We are saved!
My thanks for rescuing me. We nomads should work together. Perhaps if your leader Attila will visit our village in the west, our people can make an alliance. For now, a truce. Father Armand more about this legendary Attila the Hun, whom the stories always treat as more of a monster than a man. He was a man, the priest said, but he did not look like the Romans, nor did he worship the Roman god. That was the cause of all that was to follow. Father Armand shivered, as if from the cold breeze that blew in from the chapel's open windows. Kingship among the barbarians was not by divine right or lineage, but by who had the strongest will. Attila was the strongest of the Huns, and he reinforced his position by brandishing a rusty old blade and proclaiming it to be the sword of Mars, the old Roman god of war. Attila had a custom of fiercely rolling his eyes, as if he wished to enjoy the terror which he inspired. He had a power over other men, so that many chose to join him. Many foreigners joined his council, Scythians and Burgundians and Goths. Most notable among these was the son of a prominent Roman family, sent as a hostage to ensure peace between Romans and Huns. The name of this boy was Flavius Aetius, a name not soon to be forgotten.